my name is Nikki Randolph, and with this edition of the Queen Anne's County Veterans Update, today we are going to talk about the American Legion sponsored Boy State. And with me in the studio today, I have Larry Crouch, who is a Boy State committee member and a counselor, John Larimore, another counselor at Boy State, and we have a former participant for Boy State, Mike DeYoung, who went 2 years ago. And also, I was just informed that our cameraman is a Boy Stater from 93. And John, you went to Boy State in 80. Okay. I am surrounded by Boy Stater. So, in case you don't know what Boy State is all about, we'll get the show on the road. And John, I'll talk with you first. Tell us about what Boy State is.
The American Legion Boy State program was founded originally in 1935 in Illinois by a couple school teachers that wanted to counter the fascist summer programs for youth. Mm-hmm. So they started this program, and now 49 out of 50 states in the United States has a program. Maryland's program started in 1947 and has run continuously since.
And what is the purpose of Boy State? What is it really the purpose for?
The purpose of the program is to teach democracy. We'll start the young men in a dictatorship, and over the course of the week let them create their own democracy.
Okay, and dictatorship mean you just rule their life from the moment they get boots on the ground?
Absolutely.
Until they decide to say, okay, we've had enough of the counselors, we're going to do it our way?
Absolutely.
And that's how that works. And Mike, why don't you interject here, as you went 2 years ago, what was your first thought about Boy State when you arrived?
It definitely starts out like a dictatorship. They definitely make you make your own government, I guess, make your own democracy. Mm-hmm. Rule your city how you want to, I guess.
Okay.
Helps you, learn how politics works, I guess.
Okay,
firsthand.
All right. So it's kind of like a crash course in politics and how you run a government. So when the guys arrive at Boy State, is there any preparation? Do y'all sit them down and say, okay, this is what this week is going to be about, or is it just like a surprise every day?
It's pretty much a surprise every day. When they arrive with their parents, you know, it's a nice wholesome scene. They come in, the parents are real friendly with all of us, and we're friendly with the kids. And then parents leave, and we take charge of the kids. And at that point, we put them in a dictatorship.
In a dictatorship.
And that means we're in charge. Mm-hmm. They do what we tell them to do, and that's how we start the program. We walk them away from the parents. Parents don't see any of what's going on.
So the parents don't see the meanness that's going to happen with the boys.
Not at that point.
So in retrospect, as a veterans organization, is it kind of run like your basic training?
Somewhat. We teach them how to make their rack, their bunk.
Right.
We teach them that they've got to keep a clean, neat area. They're in charge every morning of cleaning up the barracks or the rooms that we have, the latrines, the bathrooms, all have to be cleaned. Everyone has a job. Everyone has to do it. In most cases, this is the first time any of these young men have ever had to do that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Ah, no mom and dad to do the work for you, is there, huh?
No, you're doing everything yourself.
So, Mike, give us a typical view of, since you were about 2 years ago, you went to Boy State.
Yeah.
What was it anything like how you expected it? Did we give you enough information prior, or did we just say, here's an application, we want you to go to Boy State and not give you any? I mean, are you glad that you went, or were you like, you know what, I'm going to kill them when they get back?
No, it was a definitely great and unique experience that I wouldn't have been able to get through any other program, I feel. And mm-hmm. Boy State was definitely the best program to choose if I wanted an experience like that. And there was the information that was needed about Boy State. I just didn't do the, I didn't look at it. So it was a surprise for me, but it's not a surprise for most people. They know what they're getting into when they're applying.
Right. John, how long have you been involved with the Boy State?
This will be my 19th year as a counselor.
19 years. So obviously there must be something really rewarding about Boy State.
It's very satisfying at the end of the week to see changes.
Change, growth.
Now,
do you ever have an indication where you have young men that show up to Boys State and after the parents leave, and they're like, oh no, I'm not doing this, send me home?
I'd say for the most part, 99% of the young men that we get there are high caliber, stable, responsible, good young men. They've been screened very well before they get there.
Good. All right, so how does one get involved in Boys State? How do we get young men to go to Boys State? What do we do?
Well, John and I are planning a road trip very soon, probably, to go to both the high schools in Queen Anne's County, the one in Kent County, and the one in Cecil County. I think that's probably all we'll do. And we're going to talk with the students and the counselors and explain to them what Boys State is about.
Okay.
And hopefully we'll get applications. Last year, John went to Kent County High School and he came out with 10 applications.
That's awesome.
Basically, if a young man wants to apply, he's in.
He's in.
We don't turn anyone down.
We don't turn anybody
down.
Now, there is a criteria for applying for Boys State. They do have to be finishing up their junior year in high school. In other words, in the fall, they need to be starting their senior year in high school. Mm-hmm. They have to be sponsored by an American Legion post in their county.
Right.
In Queen Anne's County, we have 3 American Legion posts that do sponsor Boys State applicants, and they just need to contact the American Legions and get an application. It does cost $300 for boys to attend Boys State, but the boys and their families are not responsible for that cost. The American Legion totally picks up and foots the bill. Mm-hmm. Am I correct on that?
Correct.
Okay.
That's right.
And then this year, I believe Boys State is going to be at McDaniel College in Westminster, Maryland.
Yes, that's correct.
Okay, now that Boys State has been held there before.
Previously, yes.
Okay, and it's also been held at the Naval Academy. Mm-hmm. And then last year, I believe you guys were at Washington College.
Last year and the year before.
Okay.
At Washington College.
Now, while they're in Boys State, they just don't sit there and clean up and clean latrines and get the 3 meals a square and do push-ups and everything. You go on field trips as well.
We do a field trip. Last year we went to Annapolis to the State House building.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And what was the gentleman's name that spoke with us, John? I can't remember.
Tony O'Donnell.
Okay. And he
Delegate O'Donnell.
Delegate O'Donnell. And he spoke to the entire group there. It was very interesting. The boys seemed to learn what really goes on in that building.
Right.
At Boys State, we have classes also. It's not just cleaning. After they clean up the mess in the mornings, we form up, we have chow, lunch, or breakfast, and go to classes. And the boys learn various things. We have speakers come in and talk to them about different
Well, what kind of classes do they take? Is it just all government-type classes, political-driven, or...?
Both. There are some people that talk about the court system. I myself got hooked into this by John because I was a banker for a long time, and I do a finance presentation. Mm-hmm. And talk to the boys, tell them how to go about obtaining credit and keeping good credit and how important it is to have good credit, that sort of thing. There are various other things. What else, John?
Nikki, probably the backbone of the program is the boys as a whole are a state, but the boys are also broken into 5 or 6 different groups that are referred to as cities. Mm-hmm. And each city is going to have its own elections for mayor, council, things of that nature, and appointments, and operate as a city, no different than Centerville or Sudlersville or wherever. Also, that city will write their own charter, which is basically the how that city's going to operate. Mm-hmm. The next layer we'll have are state elections for the state governor, lieutenant governor, attorney, and things like that. And then the final election we'll have are for 2 young men to go to Boys Nation, which is held each year in Washington, D.C.
Right.
But the backbone is to go from that dictatorship to a full-running democracy where the counselors can sit back and the satisfaction. Actually, the cities will be harder on themselves towards the end of the week than we were at the beginning.
Well, it sounds like a truly awesome, awesome program. Mike, your thoughts? Was it worth it?
Yeah. Boys Day was definitely worth it. It was great. Definitely prepared me. Helped me get prepared for college, I guess. Become an individual and just learn everything I needed to about politics and government and everything I needed to do.
Now, as you said, Boys Day has been around since 1935, so I'm assuming that there are famous people out there that were, you know, former, that attended Boys Day.
Well, a couple that come to mind. You have Bill Clinton, obviously.
Wow.
Vice President Dick Cheney.
Wow.
For the athletes, we have Michael Jordan, Rush Limbaugh, Tom Brokaw, Neil Armstrong, and a ton of U.S. congressmen, senators, state senators, state delegates, governors.
That's an impressive list.
And also a high percentage of your military academies, a high percentage of those students in the academies that have gone through the academies attended either Boys State or Girls State program.
That is extremely awesome. So it just goes to show, guys, when you're thinking about your education outside of high school, or what are you going to do with your life, it looks like Boys State, attending Boys State, is a great way to open doors further on down the road for you.
Absolutely.
So, I mean, that's a great, great program. Well, Boys State this year is June 15th through the 21st. Is that correct?
Correct.
You leave on Sunday afternoon. You have to be at McDaniel College by 1 p.m. If you show up at 1:01 p.m., they may not let you in, so because they're very stringent on that, from what I understand. And then it's next Saturday, Mom and Dad can come back and pick you up. It's a great week. I've been down there for the graduation several times, and I enjoy it. I think it's going to be awesome, but you've got to get your applications in now. We will not accept, in Queen Anne's County, all applications have to be in by April 15th. And you can pick up your applications at any of your local American Legions, or you can go to www.mdlegion.org, type in Boys State in your search program, and it will come up with all the applications and a lot more information about what Boys State is and what they do. For those of you in Queen Anne's County, if you live in Centerville, go up to Jeff Davis Post 18, and they've got the applications there. If you're in Queenstown, in Stevensville, stop by the Kent Island Post 278. I've got lots of applications in my box. I'm ready for you guys. And then, of course, Queenstown, Benedict A. Andrew Post 296. They also have applications available. Again, the cost is nothing to boys that apply, and we do not turn anybody away. So if you're going to be a senior next year, we'd like to see your name come across for Boys State. We'll be happy to sponsor you. And we're also on Facebook, so all this information that we've talked about today, go find us on Facebook. Just search Queen Anne's County Veterans Update, and the application will be there as well. This has been Nikki Randolph with the Queen Anne's County Update for Boys State this year. And gentlemen, thank you so much for coming and talking to me about it.
Thank you, Nikki.